Good morning and welcome to another Harnetty Railway documentary. Today we're on our moves, on our journeys again. Now today we're on the way to Crewe to see Oliver Cromwell head off down south for Southall, West London. As you can see, we're on our walk to the station. Now I was running a bit late due to behind the scene problems. So we're on the way to the station, we're going to get our ticket and wait for our train. We'll catch you in a bit. We are now on the outskirts of Crewe and about to be passing the Crewe Heritage Centre shortly. What's in there is what we're after. There goes a 390 Pendolino and blocking our view. And there's a disgusting looking APT. There's the Duke. Oh, damn it, that's 350, you bastard. Oh, excuse the strong language. We're now on our way into the Crewe Heritage Centre, and bad news. Before we should see Oliver Cromwell, but unfortunately, the move's been cancelled. But since we're a Crewe anyway, well, we've still got to have a look around. So, and 45305 is on site as well. Therefore, might as well carry on. Right, we are still at Crewe Heritage Centre. As you can see, the loco, which is behind me, and just found out from a friend of mine, whose YouTube name is JDT Trains, thanks for the message, Jack, that Oliver Cromwell is still going to be running, which the loco is behind the camera, right there. Oh yes, there was one thing I'm going to show you about 45305, I'm going to show you a bonus feature of this loco going through Hal Green at speed last night. On this journey back to Liverpool, despite it was making up for lost time, I tell you, it went. Absolutely tell you, it's like it was going at 60 miles an hour, or even more than that, but I'm not so sure or anything like that. But I'm going to show you the bonus footage. Roll it. Close look up of Black 545305, Alderman AE Draper. Seen on rest after a good day out the previous day on the 15 guinea special. This was built in 1936 at Newcastle upon Tyne by Armstrong Whitworth. And this loco spent most of its life in the northwest, particularly on Merseyside, particularly at Edgehill Sheds. And other places such as Lostock Hall Junction, Lostock Hall Sheds. It spent most of its life in the northwest. Almost upon withdrawal, the loco was originally supposed to have done the original 15 guinea special on the 11th of August 1968. However, the loco suffered firebox problems and was withdrawn from the trip, and in fact, withdrawn from service. Following withdrawal from service, it was sent for home for scrapping, but Alderman A.E. Draper had decided to save one Black 5, and fortunately for this locomotive, it was this one that was saved, because he said it was the cleanest locomotive in his scrapyard, which is quite a bit of a joke, really. But happily, the loco is still owned, but it is owned by the Draper family. And is looked after now by the 5305 Locomotive Association, ever since it came back on the main line. originally. It is still owned by the 5305, looked after by the 5305 Association. It's doing well. Of course, that shed code there indicates the loco was based at Lostock Hall. All sheds. And there was the plaque of the rail tour from the other day, the 15 guinea special. Although in today's money, for that amount, is £15.75. Say 1T57. And that was the actual code for the path yesterday on the 15 guineas. The loco is only 4 years back in service following a major overhaul and repairs to the boiler. Ever since the collision on the Great Central Railway, where the loco is mainly based. But this year, the loco has been based on the Keighley and Wear Valley Railway for the summer period. This summer. I mean, look at it. This is one of the best looking Black Fives I've ever seen. As you see a disgusting Class 66 shed, 66040, pass by. Anyway, it's not about tin box, this is about this. 45305. And I've actually ridden behind this locomotive twice within the last, since in July 2011 from Liverpool to Scarborough, and the other one on the Scarborough Spine, last year's Bank Holiday Monday, on the York Circular trip from York to York, before I carried on to Scarborough. This looks an absolute piece of beauty, this loco. If it hadn't been for the Draper family, this loco would not have been here today. And we thank them for that. And that concludes the guided tour of Black 5 45305, Alderman A.E. Draper. And there's the locomotive right down there we're after today. 70013, Oliver Cromwell, ready to make the move back down south to Southall. Ready to help out down at Bristol with the 5029 Nunny Castle and the 34046 Bronson, which I know this week is the Bully Pacific's inaugural trip from London to Weymouth. Now, it's not about Bully Pacific's today, it's about Oliver Cromwell and the Black Five we just seen earlier. Yeah, it's on the move back down south to Southall, ready to help out down in London. And also down in the south. Help out with West Coast Railway Company and the Railway Touring Company. And look what I found on the other side here. 84 Pacific Union of South Africa. Which you can see right there, the connecting rods have been removed. Obviously for basic general maintenance. And apparently it's going off for wheel turning soon. But it needs to be done quick because this coming Friday, the loco's on the Scarborough Flyer Express. It shouldn't take that long. But anyway, only time will tell. Yeah, we're going to see Oliver Cromwell on the move very soon. Right, we are back in Crewe Station after a brief spell in the Crewe Heritage Centre. We're just waiting now for the arrival of 70013, which I know it's over half an hour away, but it is light engine moving, it could go at any time, at any point. That depends if Network Rail allows them to go off early on an earlier path. So, we're just waiting in Crewe Station now, we're on platform 12. See a disgusting looking 350-0 coming in behind me. All in all, we're just waiting for the Brit now to head off to Southall. And so, ladies and gentlemen, Oliver Cromwell is finally on his way to us right now. Just left the Heritage Centre as I heard the cylinder cocks go off. Not an electrical tin box you can hear on the left-hand side. Should be through any minute now.
Through 12.
Right, it's on 12 as you could just hear. And there he is. Right, it's on 12. There he is.
just as the 1509 service is coming past us. And we've got a red light. No red. About time, Molly. Jeez. About time. Perfect stop right in front of us. Yeah. A perfect stop right in front of the cameras. Right, double yellow. There he goes, off down to Southall, West London, despite running an hour late.
Right, we're now going to finish the documentary here. Finally, Oliver Cromwell went past, an hour late, behind schedule. But at least it came through, didn't it? At least it didn't break down, unlike tin boxes or whatever. But we're going to end the documentary here. Because you can follow me, if you want, on Facebook. Follow me on Twitter, RichieWWLFC. Because we're at the beginning. And YouTube as well. Of course, this video as well is copyrighted by me, Richard Harnetty, 2013. If anyone tries to nick it, steer, you know the drill, whatsoever, I'm onto you. Anyway, and on that bombshell, it's time to end. Thanks so much for watching. Good night.